In this video, we're going to compare the Hyper 212 to the Hyper H412R using machine learning, using this test bench right here. Before we get started, let's look at some key metrics.
Both CPU cooler images show the side of the cooler that would face the RAM. With that in mind, both coolers will not have RAM clearance issues in most setups. Both coolers have one fan, with the H412R cooler using a 92mm fan, while the 212 cooler uses a 120mm fan. It is possible to add an additional fan to the 212 cooler, but the H412R cooler is only set up to allow for a single fan on the radiator. Installation on both coolers are very involved, require many steps, and can prove challenging for beginners. Next, let's dig into the performance. We're going to cover two sets of graphs, one normalized by percent speeds, and the second normalized by noise levels. Note that these graphs are created by using machine learning models to help break down the performance using over a million data points in an open case. This means that performance may differ depending on your case's airflow and your CPU. To orient you to the graph, the left side shows temperatures corresponding to the solid lines, with the right side showing noise levels represented by the dashed lines. As a general rule, lower is always better for the data shown. With that in mind, we'll first look at the cooler's performance on an idle CPU, which is assumed to be using 30 watts of power. When comparing the H412R cooler in red to the 212 cooler in blue, the 212 cooler performs slightly better at idle temperatures under 40% fan speed. Given that neither fan is expected to go above 50% during idle, sound is not a consideration. As we increase the watts to 105, which is what the CPU is rated for, we can see that the 212 cooler has better cooling performance across the board, with the H412R cooler struggling to keep the CPU at desirable temperatures. When considering noise, both fans don't start to make noise until approximately 60% fan speed, with the H412R cooler being materially quieter as we approach 100%. Next, we will look at the CPU overclocked to 125 watts. This shows that neither cooler can handle overclocked temperatures. Next, we will look at the performance for a given noise level. The graph shown has noise on the bottom axis, while keeping the temperatures on the side axis. Note that lower is still better for this graph. When comparing the cooler by normalized noise levels, we see that both coolers perform similarly at idle temperatures for a given noise level. As we increase the wattage to 105, both perform similarly at higher decimals. However, the 212 performs slightly better at lower decimals. This trend continues as we move to 125 watts. Overall, the Hyper 212 performs slightly better than the Hyper H412R, and they provide similar cooling performance for a given noise level. This makes this a tie for this comparison. If you enjoyed this video, you should check out this one. Thank you for watching.